Good morning, children. Let us continue with the chapter Carbon and its compound. Under that, the subtopic covalent bonds. Now, homoatomic and heteroatomic molecules. Homoatomic molecules, if the atoms participating in the covalent bond formation are the same type, the molecules are called homoatomic molecules. For example, in the formation of oxygen molecule, you can find the two combining atoms are of same oxygen atoms. The two oxygen atoms share their two electrons, or two pairs of electrons between the two combining oxygen atoms to form oxygen-oxygen double bond, is an example of homoatomic molecule. Next, heteroatomic molecules. If the atoms participating in the covalent bond formation are the different, the molecules are called heteroatomic molecules. For example, in the formation of methane molecule, you can see one carbon atom can share its four electrons with four hydrogen atoms to form carbon-hydrogen single bond. There are four single covalent bonds between carbon and hydrogen. As the combining atoms are two different types, carbon atom and hydrogen atom, and hence the molecule is known as heteroatomic molecule. Some more examples of homoatomic molecules: nitrogen, N2. You can see here the two same nitrogen atoms share their electrons to form N2 molecule. Likewise, hydrogen. You can see each hydrogen atom has one electron. They share one pair of electrons to form hydrogen-hydrogen single bond. Likewise, chlorine. The two combining atoms are of same type, same chlorine atoms. And hence, all these three are the examples of homoatomic molecules. Now, some more examples of heteroatomic molecules. Carbon dioxide, two different atoms, carbon atom and oxygen atom. Ammonia, NH3, nitrogen and hydrogen atoms, water, hydrogen and oxygen, ethane, C2H6 stand for ethane, carbon and hydrogen atoms. So, in all these four examples, the atoms are different types in a molecule, and hence these are the examples of heteroatomic molecules. Let us discuss in detail about the formation of ammonia molecule. As in case of nitrogen, there are 5 electrons in its valence shell. It requires 3 more electrons to complete its octet. And hence, a nitrogen atom can share 3 of its electrons with 3 hydrogen atoms to form nitrogen-hydrogen, 3 single covalent bond. Okay, nitrogen-hydrogen, 3 single covalent bond, and 2 electrons in the nitrogen atoms remain unshared or not take part in the bond formation. Even though it is responsible for the octet configuration, but it is not take part in the bond formation. And this unshared electron pair is known as lone pair electron. The lone pair electron, children, we can represent by small l, small p. Whereas the electrons which participate in the bond formation are known as bond pair electrons. So you have learned today two new terms, that is lone pair electrons and bond pair electrons. So in ammonia, there are 3 bond pair electrons, 1, 2 and 3, 3 bond pair electrons and 1 lone pair electrons. Now let us move for new term, that is covalency. The number of electrons which an atom of an element shares with other atoms of same or different in the formation of covalent molecule is known as its covalency. For example, children, in case of hydrogen, the two hydrogen atoms share one of its electron. That means one hydrogen atom can share only one electron, and hence the covalency of hydrogen is one. Likewise, in chlorine, the chlorine atom can share one of its electron with other same chlorine atom. Again here one electron is only shared, and hence the covalency of chlorine is one. Chlorine atom is one. But in case of water, you can see hydrogen, oxygen, oxygen, hydrogen, single bond. That means here you can see the oxygen. Oxygen is sharing two of its electron, one electron with one hydrogen, second electron with second hydrogen. That means here the covalency of oxygen is 2 because it shares two of its electron. Whereas hydrogen atom can share only one of its electron, and hence the covalency of hydrogen is 1. Now in case of nitrogen molecule, one nitrogen atom can share 3 of its electrons with next nitrogen atom. As the 3 electron being shared by one nitrogen atom, and hence the covalency of nitrogen is 3, or we can say nitrogen is trivalent in nature. Covalent bonding in carbon compounds. Children, carbon is one of the atom which can form all the three types of covalent bonds, that is single covalent bond, double covalent bond, and triple covalent bond. Single covalent bond formed by carbon atom. For example, methane. In case of methane, children, you can see a carbon atom can share 4 of its electrons with 4 hydrogen atoms to form carbon hydrogen single bond. And the number of single bond formed by carbon atom during this process, that is in methane molecule, there are 4 single covalent bonds, and these 4 single covalent bonds also represent the covalency of carbon as 4, as it shares 4 of its electrons, and hence the covalency of carbon is 4. Double covalent bond formed by carbon atom. Example, ethene molecule C2H4. In ethene molecule, the two carbon atoms, C2 stands for two carbon atoms, the two carbon atoms share their two pairs of electrons to form carbon-carbon double bond. As the two pairs of electrons shared between the two atoms, 1, 2, the bond formed between the two carbon atoms are 2. And at the same time, the carbon atoms, one carbon atom, let us name it as a one carbon atom 1 and second one as a carbon atom 2. The first carbon atom, 2 of its electron it share with first second carbon atom, and other 2 electrons it share with 2 hydrogen atoms. Likewise, the second carbon atoms, 2 of its electron it share with first carbon atom, and next 2 electrons it share with other 2 hydrogen atoms. So that you can see around first carbon atom the number of electrons 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So by sharing 2 of its electron with second carbon atoms and 2 with 2 hydrogen atoms, now the carbon atom get octet configuration, and during this octet configuration, the electronic configuration is 2, 8, which is the electronic configuration of neon configuration. Likewise, you can see in second carbon atom. Again here, the second carbon atom share 2 electrons with first carbon atom. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 2 electrons with 1 hydrogen atom and second hydrogen atom. So 2, 2, 4, 4 plus 4, 8 electrons. So the second carbon atom as well acquires the neon configuration. And hence, the combining atoms, now they complete their octet configuration by sharing 2 of its electrons. So hence, there will be a carbon-carbon double bond and carbon-hydrogen single bond. So children, you can find here the molecule contains both the type of bonds, double bond as well as single bond. There is one double bond and 4 single covalent bonds between the carbon hydrogen. Triple covalent bond in carbon atom. Example, ethyne molecule C2H2. In ethyne molecule, children, the carbon atom 1, carbon atom 2. The two carbon atoms share 3 electrons between them. That means 3 pairs of electrons being shared between the carbon atom 1 and 2 to form carbon-carbon triple bond. At the same time, the carbon atom 1 share 1 of its electron with hydrogen atom. So, you can see here the total number of electrons around carbon atom 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And with this, it acquires the inert gas electronic configuration with 2, 8. At the same time, you can see in next carbon atom 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That means it carbon atom 2 as well as the configuration of 2, 8. And that is of neon configuration. That means by sharing its electrons, it acquires the inert gas electronic configuration. And hence, the bond form between carbon-carbon, there will be a 1 triple covalent bond, and between carbon hydrogen 1 single covalent bond. So total number of single covalent bond, that is 1 and 2. There are 2 single covalent bond in the ethyne molecule and 1 triple covalent bond. Now here is a question for you children. Draw the electron dot structure of following molecules and identify A, the number of covalent bonds, B, the number of lone pairs of electrons. The molecules are carbon dioxide and water. Thank you.